As you may already know, Nissan's made a lot of great engines in the past. Everything ranging from the SR20, RB26, VQ35, VH45, and so on. They've made a lot of really good engines over the years. Now, one engine that we haven't really talked about is the VQ37. We've briefly compared it in other videos, but today we're going to dive in and take a closer look at the VQ37VHR and find out what makes it so special. First of all, welcome to another quarantine video. I have to wear a hat this video because there's no barbers open, so I can't get my hair cut. Nissan's VQ engine started all the way back in 1994, and throughout the years it's gone under a lot of different iterations and a lot of different versions. And throughout every single new version, you're going to find more power, more torque, and more reliability. Throughout all the changes, it's landed on the Ward's top engine list a lot of different times, which is kind of just a testament to how good the VQ family is. Arriving in 2008, the VQ37VHR is the next iteration of the VQ engine, and it comes after the VQ35HR. Before that was the VQ35DE. Compared to the VQ35 before it, the VQ37 obviously has a larger displacement and a lot of really neat features, which we'll talk about in just a little bit. Just like any other VQ engine, it has an all-aluminum block and an Just like other VQ engines, it has an all-aluminum block and aluminum heads, which makes it pretty lightweight considering its size. One of the distinct features of the VQ platform is the over-square design, which simply means that bore is larger than stroke. Typically, this design significantly reduces low-end torque compared to an under-square engine, where stroke is larger than bore. But in the case of the VQ37, it still has plenty of torque. Bore for the VQ37VHR measures at 95.5 millimeters and stroke at 86 millimeters. This puts total displacement at 3,696 cc's or 3.7 liters, which is where the 37 and VQ37 comes from. Power output ranges from 330 horsepower up to 350 horsepower, depending on the model that it came in, which is quite a bit more than VQ engines before it. For reference, the VQ35HR before it came with 306 horsepower in its final version, which represents a maximum power increase of 44 horsepower, while Nissan only increased displacement by 0.2 liters. It's just a testament to how really efficient the VQ37VHR is. At the top of the engine, you'll find a dual intake system, which is incredibly similar to the dual intake system found on the VQ35HR. The dual intake system has two air filters, two intake tubes, and two throttle bodies. This is simply done to increase airflow into the engine and improve throttle response. In combination with some features we'll talk about in just a moment, the VQ37 has a very, very efficient intake system. Looking more closely at the heads, we have a cast aluminum construction with dual overhead cams and four valves per cylinder. What makes the heads on the VQ37 so unique and interesting is Nissan's VVEL system, which hadn't been featured on any other Nissan engine until they released the VQ37VHR. Now, this system is unique to other variable valve timing systems because the lift is continuously variable and the timing is continuously variable. The huge benefit to having variable lift intake cams is the ability to effectively use your intake valves as your throttle body instead of your throttle body. Now, with traditional engines at very low throttle amounts, you have a really big pumping loss. You have a very big vacuum in your intake manifold. Now, this leads to basically just a decrease in efficiency, and what you're able to do with variable lift is eliminate this pumping loss by keeping the throttle body wide open at low throttle amounts and just using the intake valves instead of using the throttle body. Another interesting benefit to this type of system is reduced camshaft wear, since the intake valve lift can be kept pretty small when the throttle is open very small amounts. On top of that, the VVEL system massively improves throttle response, and it really helps the VQ37VHR have a very flat torque curve. Compared to pretty much any other V6 in its category, the VHR has a much better torque curve, and that's pretty much entirely thanks to the VVEL system. Unfortunately, VVEL doesn't really increase peak power all that much, but that doesn't really matter for when you're driving on the street. You really want good low-end and mid-range power, since you're really not going to be revving your engine out to redline going from stoplight to stoplight unless you want to get a bunch of tickets. On the exhaust side, the VHR features Nissan's CVTC system, which stands for Continuously Variable Timing Control, which, as the name implies, controls the timing of the exhaust cam. It doesn't control lift or duration, but CVTC combined with VVEL on the intake side is more than enough. To help minimize friction, Nissan used a hydrogen-free diamond-like carbon coating on the valve lifters. This is the same thing that you'll find on the VQ35HR, and that DLC coating helps reduce friction by upwards of 40%, at least according to Nissan. Moving from the heads down to the block, we've got an open deck design, which provides better cooling, although it's not quite as strong as a closed deck design, but that's really not much of an issue for a naturally aspirated engine. And we've got an all-aluminum construction, which we mentioned earlier. What makes the VHR block and bottom end interesting is a ladder frame which supports the crank. This is the exact same ladder frame found on the VQ35HR, since they share the same exact neck block. The ladder frame is employed to increase rigidity, reduce vibration, and reduce engine friction at high RPM. This is especially useful for the VQ37 because it has a longer stroke than the VQ35, which basically means there's going to be more vibration at high RPM. The graph I'm going to put on the screen here compares a VQ35DE and a VQ35HR, but the point still stands. The ladder frame on the VQ35HR obviously reduces engine vibration, and this is the same ladder frame that you'll find on the VQ37VHR. Inside the block, you'll find relatively strong pistons with an 11:1 compression ratio and asymmetric piston skirts, which are designed to further reduce engine friction. The connecting rods are nearly identical to the VQ35HR connecting rods, although they're a little bit shorter. Since the VQ37 has a larger stroke, Nissan decreased the length of the connecting rods in order to keep the same deck height. And since the 35HR and the 37VHR have the same exact block, they had to maintain the same deck height. Looking at some of the different applications which use this engine, we have pretty much everything from sports cars to small SUVs. And throughout all the different applications, the VQ37VHR was pretty much the exact same in every single application other than Nismo application. Some of these vehicles include the G37, M37, FX37, 370Z, and so on. As far as aftermarket performance, you're not going to find huge power increases when modifying this engine naturally aspirated. And that's simply for the fact that Nissan did a really, really good job of squeezing a ton of power out of this straight from the factory. I'm not saying that you won't get power out of it naturally aspirated, because you most definitely will. I'm just saying that the power increases aren't going to be something like a Chevy LS with a cam, simply for the fact that Nissan did a great job with this engine straight from the factory. Of course, forced induction is a great option, and there are some supercharger kits, some twin turbo kits, and some single turbo kits, which can bump the power of the VQ37VHR up to 500 horsepower pretty easily on a stock bottom end. All in, approximately 35% of the parts on the VQ37VHR are different compared to the VQ35HR before it, at least according to Nissan. Both engines share a lot of similarities, which we showed in the VQ35 versus VQ37 video, so we won't really go further into those similarities. Like I said before, it's all aluminum, 3.7 liter, dual overhead cam, VVEL, CVTC. It's a really badass engine, makes a lot of power for a naturally aspirated 3.7 liter engine, has a really flat torque curve, a lot of cool features. It's a really great engine. That's pretty much all I have for you guys today. It's pretty much everything you need to know about the VQ37VHR. Now, that being said, the VQ37VHR is without a doubt the best engine in the VQ lineup, at least in stock form. If there's anything you think I forgot to add or anything you want to mention, please let me know down in the comments below. While you're down there, let me know what videos you want to see in the future. Smash that thumbs up button because it really helps out the channel. Get subscribed so you don't miss out on future videos, and I'll see you guys in the next one.